launch pad. That's what this place has become for me. I have been a missionary for 25 years, but usually that meant having my feet rooted in the place where I was in ministry. 15 of those years in Ecuador, 6 years in campus ministry, and then we moved to Dayton, which isn't normally on the missionary map. But this place has become for me a launch pad to the world. The Dayton Airport has become sort of my home base to launch into Ecuador and into Cuba and into Spain as my main places in ministry. And we were talking the other day, and he said, you know, I'm not sure if the congregation knows what you really do when you disappear. So why don't you tell them? Okay. So you can go on to the next slide. I am working as a consultant for theological education in the region of Latin America, which means I have the privilege of working in places where the church is growing at an exponential rate. There's not even a way to make us comprehend how fast the church is growing in Cuba and in parts of Latin America. And what that means is, when the church grows that fast, there is an urgent need for leadership. Because who's going to shepherd all these new believers? Who's going to train all these new believers? And so I have the privilege of working with the pastors and the Bible institutes and the seminaries, the schools that are actually training leaders in these areas. In Ecuador and Cuba, that's with formal seminaries. In Spain, it's a little different story. What has happened in Spain is people from Latin America who are already believers have immigrated to Spain and have settled in Spain, have become residents of Spain, and God is using them to raise up a church in Spain, which is one of the coldest, hardest places to the gospel in the entire world. We have friends who just retired from 36 years of ministry in Spain, and only in the last 3 years did they see people come to know Jesus. But God is using these Latin American immigrants to bring the gospel back to Spain from where it went to Latin America originally. And so there's a network of people, of South American immigrants in Spain that I work with, not formal training programs, but more informal kinds of training programs. All of this has to do with 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 2, which is my life verse. The things you have heard from me in the presence of many witnesses, entrust these to faithful persons who will also be able to teach others. And so that's what I get to do when I launch out of Dayton into Ecuador and Cuba and Spain. I get to help those who are training, faithful persons, to carry out the ministry in these places. And I just want to give you one little glimpse. The three people that you see with me in the picture, this was actually taken in Indianapolis this summer because we all gathered together here. Two Ecuadorians who are living in Spain, one in La Mancha and one in Barcelona, and a Bulgarian who met Jesus in Spain, got trained in Spain, and went back to Bulgaria, as hard a place as it is to live, so that he could train Christians in Bulgaria. And he's part of our network. Everything we do in Spain, he participates in. And every set of materials that I give to the Spanish leaders, he gets them translated into Bulgarian, he takes it back to Bulgaria, and he trains others. So the first 6 months of this year, I was doing an intensive training with about 8 people in Spain. They had Bible study assignments that they did. We had a Facebook group where we interacted, and I kind of guided them through their assignments. And then once a month, we would meet via Skype or Google Hangouts or something for a classroom. And then I went over and finished that training with them. And the exciting thing about that is that these three people, along with two others from that group, are now going to train others. So within the next 6 months, there should be another 5 groups replicating that. And then those groups will replicate it. So leaders are getting trained. And that's all happening with my address at 1020 Beller Avenue, which is kind of exciting. So if you go on to the last slide, this is one thing that's very dear to my heart that I want to share with you. And the Lord really impressed this on me when I was in Cuba. Whenever that was, I lost track of which trip was which. I think it was last spring. I talked to the seminary leaders as I visit these various schools, and I asked them, if you had to list the number one thing that people could help you with, what would it be? And it's books for their libraries. The libraries I saw at the two seminaries in Cuba are smaller than the little library we have in our office here. And the books are about that old. There's probably not a book that was published after the 1950s, especially in the library in Cuba. And they're struggling to train students with a scarcity of resources. And this is something that we can do with the touch of a button. I have set up a group, a list on Amazon. If you use a computer and you know Amazon, you can go to Amazon.com, and I think it's on the right-hand side of the page, it says lists. If you click on lists, there's a space. If you type in OMS, I think if you just type in those three letters, that's all you'll need, OMS for One Mission Society. And then TET, which is Theological Education Team, it'll bring up a list of over 160 theological books in Spanish. It took me a long time to put this list together. But those are books that our seminaries can use. You click on it, you buy it, you never see it. It goes straight to OMS headquarters, and somebody will hand carry it to Cuba or Ecuador or Mexico or Colombia or to the folks in Spain. So as you're thinking about Christmas coming up and your charitable giving for Christmas, think about the needs for our seminaries. I put a little paper in the back if you want to take one that has all the steps of how you do this if you've never used Amazon before. But really simple things that we can do to make a difference in places where the church is growing at an incredible rate. So thank you for allowing me to just disappear every now and then and go off to these places. And thank you for allowing us to be a launch pad for ministry. And I appreciate your prayers. I know that every time I'm setting foot on soil in some other country that your prayers are with me. And so I appreciate that. Thank you.